Hi guys, Harry Sunday here, letting you know that there's a apparel company that supports the game that you love. It's called thereisonlyonefootball.com, guys. They've got all sorts of stuff, from caps, t-shirts, water bottles, all sorts of accessories, even for your mobile phone, all that sporting stuff you can wear anywhere you want to wear it, guys. That's right. And don't forget the website it's on, thereisonlyonefootball.com. From coast to coast, Australia, the West Indies, America, the Americas. We're talking about Great Britain, yes, Great Britain, Europe, all over the world. This is Football S Live tonight, direct. Check it out right now, guys. Hey, hup. Hit it. Check it out, guys. Hup, hup. Feel the rhythm right now, guys. Check it out. Hup,
hup,
hup. Hit it.
This
here we go, guys.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
The cup of life. This is the one.
She bangs.
How is it tough? Don't ever stop. We shouldn't know.
We should have.
Gotta be strong.
Gotta be strong.
We shouldn't know. Right from the top.
Right from
and
the
when
top.
You feel the heat, the world is at your feet. No one can hold you back if you really want it. I see it in your eyes. You want the cup of life. Now that the day's here, you're going to get it. You really want it?
And the spirit.
Get out of here, Mike.
What about
here
Huck
we
Cole?
Go. Ali, Ali, Ali.
Oh, we got the
go,
ball,
go,
the
go. Ali, Ali, Ali. Tonight's the night. We're going to celebrate. Here we go. Ali, Ali. We got people tonight, guys. We've got people tonight happening, guys. Stephanie Brantz, the cat, Peter Katholos is coming on right now, guys. It's our way or the highway. It's our pace. It's how the way it's going. It's our way. It's our way. The highway, Ruffy. What's happening on your football list tonight, sir? We're absolutely stuffed again, mate. We're stuffed.
Well, we have got good news.
Good news or bad news? I want the bad news first.
No, well, we haven't got bad news.
Are you sure?
It's all good news.
Malaka.
Horace the Crow.
Malaka. Get Malaka.
Now, tell me something. Can you book
I'm
this
losing
crow?
It, mate.
Can you book Horace in for next Wednesday?
I've got to bring him here, mate. We've got to punish the bastard.
He can sit on the chair here. No, but seriously.
Oh, God.
We went to a wedding on Saturday.
That's right, yes.
We went to the wedding of, what was his name? The production career.
Angelo
Bruckner.
Matty
and Craig Russo.
That wedding, I see.
And it was the first gay wedding we attended to.
That's nice to hear that the...
nothing wrong with that.
Nice to hear that everything's
nothing wrong with that.
Things are happening in the world the right way. Is that right?
Well, no, that is the right way. Love is love, they say.
Two little things, yes.
So congratulations.
Yes,
to them.
Fantastic.
And also, I've got to give this person a special mention tonight.
Please tell me. Oh, God.
This person is the number one supporter of our show.
Here we go again.
I've personally known this person for approximately 33 years. Given me two children. My darling wife, it's my 30th year anniversary.
We've got to give her the clap.
Great effort because it is a great effort. Because
it's a great effort, all right. Yes,
she's
yes,
been
yes.
putting up with me for 30-odd
yes,
years.
Yes,
but that's all good news. But now, listen, as you can see...
we're celebrating an anniversary tonight, too, that you don't even know.
Well, listen.
The 200th
what
show.
What I'm going to do...
We're going to do a 200th show next week.
I've had my tops return. Can I just quickly say this? Let me get down to this. The goodies are back for sale.
Oh, really?
They got returned to me because they were too small for the young fella. So there it is. We've got the Crazy John shirt there.
Well, we can bid on tonight. We can bid tonight,
yes,
can't we?
Yes, yes. It's officially for sale. There it is.
For sale, guys.
It's medium
to large
size.
Unbelievable stuff, you guys. Unbelievable stuff,
and also, we've got the great Mehmet Dirakovic here.
Yes, yes,
there
yes,
you go
yes.
There. This is the original top day wall back in the air. Yes,
but of course,
and
but
there's
of course.
The front of it there, Coca-Cola Phillips. National,
gee, that's
humble.
The Coca-Cola Coca-Cola
yeah,
League,
yeah,
mate.
And all that.
Oh,
and,
God.
And one other thing here, I might as well, I'm parading the great the great keeper's top.
Oh
here.
My God! Is that there, Brad? Is that Brad Jones?
That's
is it?
Brad Jones there. That's the
Brad keeper. Jones. Brad Jones.
That's the keeper's top there.
Unbelievable,
now,
mate.
Listen, before we get on, before we move on with the show, I am not separating. I'm not separating these three items. It's $600.
Come on, mate.
$200 a pop. Well, look, it's original gear. Now, this is an icon. This is the last of the NSL South Melbourne.
It's got to be worth $500 itself.
Well, I'm going... What am I laughing at?
Well, yeah, sit down, you bloody idiot. It's not the tennis here again,
okay?
Are they
Preston supporters, aren't they?
I'm pressed for time.
Yeah, you're pressed for time. But anyway, $600 for the three tops. So
$50. $50. John Sass is $250 for that one. $250.
$250.
Do I hear three hundred? John Sass $250. $250. John Sass. $250. John Sass. $250. John Sass. Once.
Hold twice. On. I'm going to be happy with
cash,
that sale.
Cash. You got cash. It's cash money
cash
as well.
Cash too.
Cash.
Well, if you make it $300, I can throw in this top as well. How's that?
Remember this movie? Show me the money.
Show me the money. Well, there you go. So, it's a bit of a South Melbourne night tonight because the boys are, look, let's be honest.
The boys are on top,
are they? They're on top of the ladder.
Yeah, but I don't like this. They're not in a bigger competition than what they are. You know that, don't you?
Well, one day, the relegation promotion will happen.
That's right, yes, it will.
2023, is it, or something?
That's it, 2023. Again, it keeps getting older and older. That's what happens.
I'll tell you what, Mr. Sunday, when that happens, you'll see this great team rise at the top.
There it is there.
And there it is there, yep. It's.
Can you show that?
Yes, yeah, so let's.
I used to blow a lot in that, you know.
You used to blow a lot there.
I used to blow there, mate.
And unfortunately for your team, $250
only.
$250 for which one? The Crazy Johns?
The Crazy Johns one, yes, the last year of the NSL, that's right.
Well, that's good as sold, that.
Okay.
And so when the promotion relegation happens, your team will fall and this team will rise at the top.
Do you know who's coming on tonight?
Who we got?
Stephanie Brantz comes first.
Stephanie Brantz.
And we've got the cat. The cat.
Oh, the cat.
He's going to stir the cat up. I can tell you that right now.
Well,
we have a situation tonight, guys, where the cat is coming on to plead with everyone about Andrea. Crazy Andrew.
Crazy Andrew
used to go to the games at Olympic during the NSL period.
John,
he did so much hard work, and he's actually living in a caravan, and we're not happy about this.
Well,
a cat will come on. Peter Katholos will come on and talk about this, guys. But we got to get Miss Brantz on. Let's talk about something quickly before we get Miss Brantz on. Now, guys, anybody out there hear that Manchester United want to buy Central Coast Mariners?
What Jesus on earth is going on there?
Mate, must be bargain basement right now.
Now, what's Matty Simon up to? Has he made private phone calls to the Manchester United hierarchy?
Yes, he has, yes.
And now you know what's going to happen,
Ole Gunnar Solskjaer,
whatever you... Who was that?
He's the coach. What's wrong with you?
I thought he was a cleaner
Manchester United legend, and he's the coach there. He's got him second on the ladder. Second on the bloody ladder.
I've always thought if you stayed as Man U, sounds like a game.
Well, you know what my point is? My point is this about is this it? Sale of the Mariners United. Mariners United right now, guys, I'm sure they're going to be wearing red too. So that's the thing. Well, I think because Melbourne City or Manchester City actually own Melbourne City, they're trying to create a derby here, aren't they? A derby, the two Manchesters in Australia, of course.
Well, not that long ago, if you recall, it was about 3 years ago, the great Liverpool were interested in taking over Brisbane Roar.
Yes, of course, but of course.
Apparently, they weren't rumours, it was sort of on the cards and stuff.
Stop laughing, please, sit down and shut up.
Well, it was sort of a...
Get the hell out of your mug.
Wish off your
Yeah, the microphone only fell.
Jesus
the microphone
Christ,
only fell out.
Bloody Tuesday, what the hell's wrong with him?
He flew past the microphone and he took it out. The bludger.
He's got to be a Preston supporter, wouldn't he be?
We're pressed for time. We're pressed for time at the moment.
So we've got a young lady on tonight.
Got a young lady. And don't forget, guys, I've just come up with something right now. They're saying that nine world-class broadcast bidders are bidding for the A-League. Are we kind of like... We're talking about maybe... How much is it going to cost to go see an A-League game on TV now? Let's watch this space as well.
Well, whatever it costs, let's get down and support the boys because...
That's right, exactly.
And Steph agreed last time.
Of course.
She agreed.
Mate, we have a lot to talk about with Miss Brantz here tonight, Miss Brantz, because of the what's happened with the W-League as well. My God.
Well, the W-League, we've got the Matildas got... copped half a dozen.
Well, I saw that
from the Germans.
What is the Germans are very hard girls. You know, they're very
They're
hard.
Very hard.
They're very hard, hard girls. You know how hard they are, don't you?
And I've got some questions for young Stephanie.
Of course, of course.
Some interesting questions, and let's see if she can give me of the course. Right answers.
Yes.
And we'll put her to the test. So, so now have we got the cat first, or have
we got Miss Brantz first, Miss Brantz.
So, well, let's give her a tingle. How's that?
Let's see if she's there first of all.
Well, let's see if she answers.
Is she going to let us down tonight? Come on, here we go.
Let's have a look. Have a look.
Are you ringing there, Steph? Come on, mate. Come on, Miss Brantz. Just let me talk to her. They're booing us. Hello. No, she's not coming on, is she?
Maybe she's run out of
time. Miss Brantz, are you there? Have you let us down tonight?
Let's have a look, Miss Brantz. Maybe I'll play your favourite tune.
Hello?
Hi, you've reached Stephanie. I can't take your call right now.
Oh, my God, she's busy.
Name, number and any message, and I'll call you back as soon as I can. Bye.
Miss Brantz, this is Footballess. I thought you were coming on tonight, so we're leaving you a message to call us back. So let's see what we can do right now. Okay, now, Frothy, do we have any more information on what's going on here
Look,
right now?
Please
get on with it. We'll get her back on. We will get her
we'll
on. Don't worry.
We'll get her back on. We'll get her back on.
Yes, now, we'll get her on.
We got lots of information.
Yes, yes, yes.
Now,
please tell me some stuff.
Well, you covered the 30... Man U, yeah.
I can't believe that.
Now, are these rumours or is it going to happen? I can't see it happening. Well, what? Just because Central Coast are top of that? And you know what? You know what? I'm gonna take back what I said three or four weeks ago.
Yes.
I think the Mariners are the real deal.
Are you for sure about that?
I. Well.
They're bloody laughing at us, mate.
They seem, and it's good. It's good for Australian football. There's only
Australian football? Which football?
Yeah,
there's so many footballs here, mate.
Well, the real football.
I want to talk about these footballs up here.
This football
footballs.
Here.
That's right.
Look,
yes.
it's a good story. They're proving me wrong every week. They win almost every week.
Yes,
now,
yes, yes.
I'll tell you what a story. What did they finish last year? They finished
yes,
second last.
Yeah, second last. Now, I couldn't believe this, guys.
To come from that position to be pressing to win the toilet seat, is it the coach or is it the players? I believe it's a coach.
The coach.
He's had them for a while.
And
they're
just,
blending in.
Well,
they're learning his way that he wants them to play. And I've seen their games and they are playing very, very, very good football. And that's no crap.
Attacking and attractive football, which is everybody wants to see
and
hear. That's
God,
right.
They knock the ball around like no other team. I'll tell you what.
Well, let me tell you something right now about that. And
tell
you
me
look,
something
you look
right
at Stajic. Stajic. You look at Stajic the way he coached the Matildas.
Yes. Well,
and they were a winning team. Now, look at the Mariners and look at the Matildas right now. You know the Matildas, what's going on right now. There's a 6-2 or what was it, man?
6-2. Now, it just goes to show you that they... Well, the German girls brought them down to earth, as they say.
Peter Petru says something to us in Greek. Peter,
can you
please, Peter, say something to us that... say something in English so we can understand what that means.
The international language.
Crazy men.
Crazy John.
Crazy John. John's up there.
Now, hold on.
I would not show that to Peter because all I can say is, Alexandros. Alexandros.
Because he follows Heidelberg.
He will actually burn that if you show him that. Peter, will you burn this shirt, please?
I don't care. If he gives me 200 big bananas, he can do whatever he likes with it.
That's quite a large shirt. What size is that shirt, anyway?
Well, it's a medium to large.
Medium to large?
Yes, it's an in-between there. Well, you wore that 3 years ago.
Yeah, look how stretched it is now.
It's a bit stretched, and there you go, Peter Petru. So now, how's John Saz going? Has he put in more offers?
Well, John Saz is not talking right now, guys. He's not talking.
Well, I'll tell you what.
Well, we're going to try and get Stephanie on if we can.
I suppose. Now, listen, we see the A-League. I don't know what games you saw over the weekend.
I didn't want to see any of them, mate.
Now,
a Melbourne victory won, didn't we? There you go, mate.
Well, Melbourne victory won, but let me tell you, it was circumstances why you won.
Circumcisions?
It's not because...
Circumcisions?
Circumcision. Now, I'll tell you what, let's not get onto that.
Circumcisions?
Now, listen, yes, you won. Look, I've got to give you that. You finally won a game, and that was always going to happen. You were going to win another game before the end of the season. But it was circumstances why you won.
Oh, this is...
It's not because you dominated.
Now, gentlemen... Gentlemen, please, can you just all please be quiet and say...
Calm down.
Calm down. What's happening online here with you guys talking about the shirts? And apparently, please don't say eggs on toast, John, because we have a South shirt South shirts burn a lot easier. Is that right? So I would not be fighting you tonight, gentlemen. Okay, please, boys. Thank you. You don't fight tonight, guys. Thanks.
I want serious. I want serious bitters. Now, listen. Taylor Regan. You know who Taylor Regan is?
Taylor Regan, yeah.
Now, do you know who he is?
Yes, he is.
Now, he's not a boxer. He's not a chef. Now, Taylor Regan is a retired A-League player. A very good one, may I add.
I see what you mean.
Now, he's put in a big claim. Now, you said this a little while ago. There's going to be a massive... Now, this is a Greek word. Exodus, is it?
Exodus.
Now, you're Greek, you know that?
Yeah, Greek.
Of A-League Greek, players again.
Greeks don't want no freaks, yeah.
That's about true.
It's about true.
But listen, now the A-League, I'll tell you what, we know, we spoke about this weeks ago.
Yes.
70% of the players are uncontracted.
Oh, we know what's going on
and
here.
And there's a lot of money in India.
Oh, we know that.
Now, they better quickly
they're
sign
about,
them
they're
up.
They're about to start that league, you know, don't you?
Because Rudy Rudin...
Oh, he's gone, mate.
...has that, done mate. It again.
He's a mate.
He has replaced our mate Bessart.
Has he replaced him again? Is he giving it to him again?
I just don't get it.
Did he give him this on the way? I heard he gave him this time.
Well, Bess wasn't happy again. And
get
mate,
back to Melbourne victory, will you, mate? Jesus Christ.
Well, he should go where he started from, the great Brisbane up there. Well, that's where they got him from.
Oh, well, what can you say?
But listen, you cannot, and Archie Thompson said this, you cannot replace, you can't sub players to that calibre.
Yes.
The guy's in good form.
I'm going to call somebody in a minute again. If we can get her on.
Stephanie
Brantz. If she wants to come on.
Well, let's have a look. Let's give her another go.
We'll see if she's not on. We'll call the cat. No, she's not on.
Well, give it another wait a couple of seconds.
She won't be on. We're going to call the cat early
tonight.
She
might be in the little girl's room. You don't know.
I don't know.
You never know.
Hello, Stephanie, you there? No, she's not there, guys. We're going to bring the cat on in a minute, guys.
Well, let's get the cat on. I mean,
we'll try and get the cat on, mate. Let's get the cat on, please.
Let's see what the cat's got to say.
Let's get the cat on, mate, please.
Get the cat on.
Yeah, I bet you he stuffed us up too tonight. Hello.
Hello, Harry.
How are you, Peter? Welcome, Peter Katholos, to Footballers. How are you tonight? We got you on early tonight. There you go.
How are you, boys? I'm live on air. How's it going?
We are live on air. We got that many people on tonight, Peter. We got the bloody whole of Australia on tonight watching us about what's happening with Andrew. He's playing the South Melbourne bloody thing. Stop blowing. We're blowing too hard tonight, mate, as you can hear it.
Hey, Kat. Now, listen, Kat, I don't know if you're watching. I've got some.
Oh, Peter, you want to see what's going on tonight, mate? I'll tell you what, Peter.
And I'll fit you because apparently you're only 5 kilos over playing weight. So
what?
I handpicked these jumpers for you. We've got the Crazy John's jumper here. We've got the old retro Mehmet Jurakovic, one player you feared, they say. Apparently, didn't have much luck against him. And, well, what do you got to say about our mate Mehmet? You reckon he's one of the greatest socceroos ever to play in the back line? Now, fill us in, Kat.
Come on, Peter.
Mate, listen, Mehmet was a top bloke. He was a good player.
He was.
I never feared him. No, I never feared him as a player. I respected him.
Yes.
And, look, he was a great player. He served his country well, and he should be very proud, and we're very proud of him.
That's clean, right. Fair, strong, quick, aggressive. Yet he had everything. I'll tell you what, along with our mate Milan Ivanovic and some great forwards going around those days.
Hang on, mate.
Katholos. Who was that guy?
You never talk about Peter here.
I just said it.
Peter, we saw that game last week. I saw this game last week that you played with the... what's his name? We interviewed him
Peter
last
Henderson.
Week.
What was his name?
Tony Henderson.
Tony Henderson.
You were on the ground when you saw that goal scored. Is that right? When he went right through those little what do they call them? Those blokes.
Well, the little
Taiwan.
Guys,
remember that, Peter?
Taiwan. My old teammate. Yeah, he's a great. He was a great player, mate. Great leader. We had good times on my county. Fantastic,
mate. That guy. I've watched that goal. That many times I'm thinking it gets better every time I watch it. And Hugh Johns gets
Hugh John.
I could not
Hugh
believe how fantastic he's screaming. Hugh Johns was so subdued, and this guy screamed, "That's how you beat an offside trap." Here you go.
Yeah.
He just barged.
Yeah, look, Tony Henderson was a great footballer. Look, he was the original, I think he was the original Socceroo. I think he took over after Johnny Dorley.
Yes.
But, look, for a guy that played sweeper, he was very technical.
Guys, The stream is low. We're back again, guys. That was right down. We're back again. Ooh. We've had some problems. We're going to finish the show a little bit in the way we can do this. So if we can call Stephanie Brantz and see what we can do, guys.
Just about 15 minutes.
About 15 minutes if we can get her on, guys. That's about it. So,
young Stephanie.
So what we need to do is find out what we can do here right now and try and finish this show, because we've had difficulties with Telstra. It was Telstra all the way through. And
it
we're
was.
Trying to. It was Telstra all the way through.
It is.
Frothy.
We know that. We confirm that.
And they're still
it's
laughing.
It's beyond us. Our control.
Beyond our control that Telstra having problems, and we have to try and fix this matter that we've got up. And
By
next Tuesday we'll have this fixed up. I'll be here on Monday night working on trying to fix this problem up, guys. So
let's call Stephanie before we go off again.
If we can get Stephanie on here, guys, and see what we can do.
And let's see if young Steph is still up. Well, maybe it's past her bedtime.
Let's see if we can get her on now, guys. Here we go.
She might have a cup of tea there.
Here we go. Let's see if we can get her on, guys. Here we go.
Teddy bear biscuits and a...
Hello?
Hello.
Is that Miss Stephanie Brantz? Is that right?
It is. I'm so sorry. You were in my pocket.
I was in your pocket. We are always in your pocket, Miss Brantz. You know that.
It's a frightening thought.
Miss Brantz, we had problems. Telstra stuffed us right around. Telstra, bloody Telstra. Would you believe this?
Yes, Telstra. So
they'll be stuffing us around, Miss Brantz.
It sounds like
it sounds like when I say Miss Brantz? It sounds like Mr. Squiggle. Mr. Squiggle. What's her name? Miss. What was her name? Miss.
It sounds like a school teacher, Mrs. Yeah. Brantz.
No,
Mrs.
that was
Brantz
Mr. Squiggle. What was her name? That lady that was saying, yeah, I remember. I mean, yes.
Now, young Steph, I've got the Greek name, but look, we'll only probably go 15 minutes. We've had issues with Telstra, and that's a fact. Unfortunately,
that's right.
So I think half the people have gone to bed, Harry. But
of course, there's a few up right now. Actually, we've got more people coming on right now. There you go.
We three are up, and now check this out, Stephania Brantzopoulos. Now
you Greek.
That's
name.
What your name would have been if you were Greek. Now listen. We're going to get on to the W League here since
we got you.
But now, first of all, can you name this person? Now, you're going to love this. Now, listen up here. Now, this person back in 1985 apparently had a bit of a modelling career.
Really?
Born 1972.
Elle McPherson.
You're close. Began her television career in the year 2000.
Yes.
Rumour has it, Steph, that this person is about 6'5" with...
Really?
Shoes on.
6'5".
And apparently this person is worth about 5 million big bananas.
We'd like you to sponsor us right now, thank you.
Now, is that you, Steph?
Not the $5 million, I can tell you that.
So that's a lie. I got that off the internet, and they said she's worth about $5 million.
Glad you think I'm worth $5 million, thank you.
Well, you're worth every cent, but I tell you what, I've got a serious question for you here. Now, you cover all the sports. Now, we're going to go to cricket for 1 second. I just want to explain something. You watch the men cricketers, they just hold the bat, they hit the ball, they run and they bowl and they field. Football, you've got the Socceroos versus the Matildas. Now, what would it take? Now, this is an interesting question. I've never asked this before.
It sounds like it already.
Now, this is to a commentator who knows...
Get out of here, mate.
Horace the Crow
keeps coming past us, mate.
Every bloody Tuesday night. Now, listen, tell him to piss off, will you?
Go away, will you?
What would it take? Now, what is the difference? Why can't the Matildas beat the men? Now, are they a bit slower? Are they a little bit weaker in their tackles? Aren't they as skillful? What would it take for a women's team to beat a man's team in football? Do you have the solution?
Double the girls'
can
team.
Can it be done?
Now, I have asked numerous coaches of some fame about this, because people whinge all the time when we put our senior women's teams up against 15-year-old boys.
Wow.
And
yes, exactly.
They get beaten.
That's true.
Reason is, now, apparently it's scientific and biological, because that is exactly the age where the boys shoot up, they become physically stronger, and they can just muscle players out of the game, and that's apparently the most appropriate matchup. And it's at some point, it's like midpoint in their season as well. It's they've looked at it really specifically, but apparently it is about the physical nature of the game. They're just so much stronger because men are, well, not all men, but
actually, I have an idea. I have an idea about that theory. This is science according to Sunday, right?
Okay.
Now,
Sunday science.
We had all the Matildas bulk up like bodybuilders, could we beat them?
Can we not even discuss
What's wrong with that? I think that'd be bloody bigger than the bloody Socceroos.
Well, Steph, the fact is the Matildas are better than the Socceroos, if you get the drift, aren't they? They are better on the world stage, which is...
Well, in like for like, competing against their own gender, then yes.
Of course.
If you go on results and you go on rankings, yes. then yes, exactly, exactly right. The Matildas are seventh in the world. But even with the women's game, you can see the gulf in perhaps... quality of their play between, you know, the top teams in the world and those yes. further down. So it's, I mean, we've seen that they played Germany, and Germany were just technically and tactically yep. beautiful to
yep.
watch.
Yep.
Of course, we were coming into that, you know, off a standing start. We haven't been together in 400 days, and that's Germany true. Has been doing Euro qualifier, yep. so it's not quite yep. a fair assumption. But the Netherlands are going to be interested because they're not going to be any easier tonight tomorrow morning.
Well, what is? Are you going to be staying up to watch that, Miss Brantz?
Well,
do you know what? I have to stay up to watch it because there's no way if I go to sleep I'll get up. I'm not good at the getting up early.
You don't want to watch you don't want to watch the replay, do you? Because you're going to know the result after. Is that right?
Well, you've got to keep your phone off if you're going to do that. Thank and everyone you. Picks up their phone first thing in the morning.
Now, I want to talk about. I'm going to speak to you about Ms. Brantz about the Melbourne victory. Now, what I will say is exactly the same thing about the men and the women. The women are on top. Okay. The women are on top. The men are on the bottom.
Yes.
And this is a consolation for the girls and the boys. How's that? What do you think?
Yeah. Now I'm wondering whether the Melbourne Victory women could meet the men. Could beat the men.
That could be. I think if we had big sponsors, I reckon they'd put money down for that.
Yeah, I still think it's not a like-for-like match, but gee, you feel for the guys, and congratulations to the women. Their team was fantastic.
Yes, yes, yes.
Well, why in cricket? I mean, you know your sport. Why in cricket? Why can't the women cricketers beat the men cricketers? I mean, there's no physicality there. You know, you hit the ball, you bowl, and you field.
Do you know what? I wonder if that might be the tightest contest, because we've seen in our women's and men's tennis, it doesn't quite match up. In golf, the women play off different tees.
Yes.
Yeah,
but I wonder if in cricket, of course, our fast bowlers wouldn't be as quick as the men. And
it doesn't matter.
Yep.
She played with modified boundaries. And
I see what you mean.
Exactly.
Yeah, it could be close. You guys should get that started.
Well, you know,
equal pay wages, they say. I mean, people do the same job, and because, look, you know, I'm not sticking up for any gender. I'm just saying, we're just talking, and basically how can we get the Matildas to potentially beat the Socceroos? But, you know, you go for the same job, and you're doing exactly the same job, but, you know, you're a woman, you're going to get less. I'm serious. Don't be biased.
Welcome to our world.
Welcome to our world.
Why?
Please. I'll ask you one. Please don't be a politician after what I've seen.
Look, I support the girls, Steph, because I've been happily married 30 years, and it's my anniversary tonight. And so I figured, you know what? We are all just as important, you know, men, women. And apparently there's a lot of genders out there. We won't discuss that.
Please, thanks.
But I'm just trying to see how we can get the Matildas to give the Socceroos a crack. But, I mean, look.
Well, the only problem with that, though, and congratulations on your anniversary.
Thank you very much.
But the only problem, if the Matildas beat the Socceroos, what does that do for marketing for the Socceroos?
Not very good.
Atrocious.
Oh, my God.
We call it the jelly bean game. How's that?
Oh, God. I tell you what, but look, there's other sports, like table tennis. I mean, I don't know.
They play mixed doubles in tennis. You know that.
Tennis, they play mixed. Well, then again, Serena Williams. She could beat half the men's draw. I'd say. I mean,
here we go.
She's got a serve off.
This is a football show. A football soccer show here.
Football. Melbourne Victory.
Now, I will just tell you right now.
And I beat my team, unfortunately.
Yeah, but I'll tell you, Stephanie, about this. That goal that was scored, that winner.
Was it a goal?
What's going on? What is
Something
going on
going
here?
On there? Didn't like
I mean,
that.
I just saw that. Was it a mistake by the goalie? Was the corner too close to the girls and they misjudged it? What's going on here? You saw that?
Do you know what?
Happening.
I think it took a deflection. Great corner from Karakuni Cross.
Yes,
and just
yes.
a shame for Jada Wyman, who had an exceptional match. It was such a shame
God.
For her.
That's true. That's
and
true.
I mean, the Victory women were like really weren't in the hunt for the finals at the beginning. Is that right? And they just
well,
made. Is that right?
Do you know, 5 weeks ago they're in fifth, and had they lost that match at Epping Stadium that week, they would have missed out on finals football. So it's a stunning effort from them, and Jeff Hopkins has been fantastic. So, you know what, they came in with a wet sail and did a brilliant job.
I'm sure Anthony Di Pietro will be very happy about that, actually.
I'm sure Anthony Di Pietro will be very relieved to have a good news story coming out of the victory.
What was that?
We went to that game at Epping.
We saw that game, you know that?
We went there.
We didn't see you, though.
Thanks
for coming to say hello.
Oh, we should bloody say hello next time. Come on, mate,
we didn't want to. We weren't dressed for the occasion. I mean, Harry was wearing his shorts and he didn't shave his legs. But listen, Richie Garcia, did you see his interview? He went crazy. Did you see that against who were they playing? They were playing Sydney FC, were playing the Glory. Yes. And they ended the match a couple of minutes early through thunderstorms and electrical thunder bolts or whatever. And then they interviewed the players on the ground.
You're joking.
Yeah, I was at that match. That was an extraordinary finish.
You weren't holding your microphone,
mate.
No, I wasn't.
Thank God.
It had been
that.
Delayed by 50 minutes at the start. So it was a bizarre night.
Crazy.
Well, that's what. Player safety. And then they just casually. I think Bozza was out there interviewing some players there. And everyone was saying, get them off the ground before a lightning bolt comes.
I'd like to do
that.
That
was a whole idea.
Actually, I want to do
what are you going
to
do?
I'm going to try and pretend to be, you know what I'm talking about.
Not
Bozza,
really.
Bozza. I'm going to do a Bozza thing. Well, I'm going to try and be Bozzy.
Well, he's got that.
That's the way he laughs.
Wow, my God. Now, Steph, before we go, this is an easy NSL A-League comparison here, and I know you're going to know these two players. Now, it's a bit of a trick. Michael Theoklitos, as an NSL player.
Theo,
He played, Michael, now he's Michael Theo.
Yep.
Now, I've picked these two greats because you support the great club I support, and I've picked Michael Theo versus Jamie Young. Now, what a hard comparison. Now, who do you go for there?
Oh, that's a really tough... I like Jamie Young.
Jamie Young, yeah.
I do,
I've met Jamie, yeah.
I do too, yeah. But Harry's got a photo with Jamie Young.
Yeah, I've got a photo with Jamie Young.
When we went and saw Western United.
That's right.
Harry's actually a Brisbane supporter. Don't be fooled with his crap, all his victory.
Jesus Christ.
He's lived in Brisbane for 40 years, for heaven's sake.
You know,
a loaded question.
Yes. I just say, no comment.
Now, listen, I would go for Michael Theo, Theoklitos, only because when there's a corner, Jamie Young, I don't really trust him as far as corners go, if you know what I mean. He doesn't seem
to have
that
thought on a goalkeeper.
Well, you know, I mean, Theoklitos a couple of inches taller, and Jamie Young's clearance again on the weekend, straight to the opposition. I never saw Theo do that. But anyway, two great keepers, there's no doubt. I mean, it's a toss of a coin. But can I hit you with this question here? Let's see if you know what I'm talking about. Four La Liga championships, three times Champions League, this person's won, three Brasileiro Serie A championships.
Really?
Two Intercontinental Cups, two Copa Americas, one World Cup, Ballon d'Or runner-up.
Jesus.
Now, this is the clue. 125 caps for Brazil. Do you know who we're talking about? Young Steph, isn't he? Do you know who
Are you for real?
About? Yeah, a bit of information there. Now, let's check it out.
That's a lot of information. I get to know when he was Ballon d'Or runner-up?
No, I didn't search that, but I'll tell you something right now. No, he's a ball man. He played as a ball man. Now, there's another
Ronaldo.
Clue. Roberto Carlos.
Yes.
The golden ponytail.
He was supposed to be the coach of South Melbourne in the A-League.
Was a crap that was going on. But
bloody hell.
That, obviously, you remember, Steph, the great Roberto Carlos free kick. I haven't seen a better goal in my life.
I was going to go for Neymar halfway through that, but then he didn't play for all the clubs that you mentioned.
Okay.
Neymar, yes.
I have something very serious here now. We're going to get very serious here.
Well, hold on. You're not going to ask her out,
What
do you mean?
A few weeks ago, we couldn't get you on, and we did have some information that we were going to tell you, and we'll tell you right now. What's happened is, at one of the W League games, it was 5,100 people.
Now,
marvellous. I love it.
Were you there?
I was there. It was amazing. It was fantastic.
Are we talking about the women's competition at that day? Were more people at that game than the A-League games separately?
Well, I think so.
I just cannot believe this. Honestly, I'm saying to myself, why couldn't these people? Now, was this at a certain park, or was it at Epping, or was it a certain...
It was at Coopers.
Cooper Stadium at Hindmarsh, yes. That's right. So that would have been like a double header before the men's game, is that right?
No, it was a standalone match.
That is, I don't know whether I've ever seen the Matildas are the Matildas. People will go and watch them, okay? But as a women's W League game, to have that many people there when there was no men's game on at that after that, that is an amazing that achievement.
It's sort of a bit unbelievable, isn't it?
I mean, look, it looks the stadium might look empty, but it's got a lot of people still on. Is that right, Ms. Brantz?
Yeah, it was a record crowd for a standalone regular season game, which was brilliant. They marketed it well. I think there are a couple of factors in play. They had two community business supporters.
Yes.
I think one was South Australia Power and one was, I want to say, My Home Banking, or I should remember that. Apologies to that particular company. They put the money in to buy out the stadium. Yes. And then entry was free.
My God. No wonder they turned up.
Also, that was the week before, if you recall, they were looking at announcing the World Cup stadiums.
Okay, that's the thing.
So there was a big call for support, and I'm independent of that, they may still have got that because Adelaide were fighting very hard for a spot in the finals, first time ever.
Now,
So they had a great team, a great season, and I think there were myriad factors at play. But it shows that if you do it right, people will come.
Okay,
that's true. Exactly.
What I will ask you right now is. Are we going to see the Matildas, as we spoke about the Matildas playing this morning, they're playing against Holland or Deutschland, or the Dutch, whatever.
No. The Dutch.
Now, well, you're
another loss coming up for the Matildas.
You got a Dutch background.
Absolutely.
I do. My parents are Dutch, and they're playing in Nijmegen. I'll come out there.
Okay. Now, let's just see what happens here.
And she follows his great.
Are you going to be following both teams today or what?
No, I can't do that. I was born in Australia. The Matildas are my first team. Okay. I do have an orange jersey, though, to be fair.
Well, I'll be fair with you, Steph. Like I said, not many people watch the show, but I guarantee you'll be going for the Dutch.
We have a very sad story. We had Peter Katholos on earlier, but we had some difficulties with the Wi-Fi, of course, Telstra Wi-Fi stuff.
Yes.
Now, we've got the information there. Peter may be listening right now. We have a gentleman by the name of Andrew, Crazy Andrew, they called him. He was the, how can we say this, one of the most popular people at Sydney Olympic during the NSL period. And apparently he did so much work at Sydney Olympic, Stephanie, that he's lost his two houses. And he's living in a caravan park for 7 years. We can't get Peter on that, but what we want to say to everybody out there right now, we have that information up there. They've raised $19,000 in 2 days. We have given some money ourselves. We put some money in ourselves. We didn't put enough, but we put something in. It doesn't matter what you put in, because the guy was basically a legend of the club itself at Olympic.
He's an icon, of course.
And and everybody didn't realise that he'd lost his two houses, and he's been living in a caravan park for the last 7 years. So, guys, if everybody's out there right now, and you just scroll up and you'll see Andrew's post. Somebody put a post there about Andrew.
So he wants some money, doesn't he?
So, look, even if you can give $1, $2, $3, everybody's giving all sorts of money there to help the guy.
Well, Steph's worth $5 million. Maybe she can chip in $500, maybe.
And, Stephanie, Peter told me earlier that in May, and Peter has that information, and we'll try and get it off him, that they're going to have a dinner for him. A dinner at the Marconi Club, which means I think maybe you'd want to come out there and have a dinner or something. Because actually, I'm hoping that I'm going to be out there that day too to try and help. I think the Football S crew is going to be going to do a show there. Hopefully, fingers crossed, and we might interview you live around everybody. How's that?
Oh, that'd be lovely, and that'd be great to support such a legend of the club.
I just can't believe it, Stephanie. The guy has never asked for help. Never asked for help.
Well, all the soccer community has come together.
And what's happened
is... they're supporting him. They're giving him some cash.
Of course. And they did some post out there a few days ago. And I looked at it, I said, you're joking. The poor guy lost his... And these are the people who have done so well in the beginning in their lives and lost things. And this guy has actually... I just can't believe what he's lost. And somebody spoke to... As Peter Katholos spoke to me earlier, he just can't... And he didn't even know. And apparently, it's his best man. Peter was his... Apparently, Andrew was Peter's best man, Peter Katholos' best man, at the wedding. So I can't believe this.
This sounds like a joke.
This is true. And Peter didn't even know that he was in a caravan park up to today. Nobody knew that. Jesus.
This is a really sad story.
Yeah. And I'm sure Jack, you probably met Jack Zervos, is that right, in Sydney as well?
I have at one stage, yeah.
Yeah, and Jack does the and I'm sure Jack is organising something as well there too for that. So at the Marconi Club in Sydney, and if you guys are out there now listening to us, this is really important that sometimes some people who've put all their heart into their club, whether it's an NSL club or an A-League club, please help them because they were volunteers. They didn't get paid for anything. They were there every week doing their thing. And you know, Stephanie, you know in the W League, there's a lot of people there who are all not professionals there, and they're all volunteers. And you've probably seen a lot of volunteers,
And we've
Stephanie.
Done that.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I think it's really important that it's at times like this, you know, we accept all the volunteer help, but this is when the football community's got to come together and help their own.
And we're hoping to get this. I hope in the next couple of days it gets up to 50,000 because this guy's lost. He's lost everything.
Yeah.
He has lost everything, and nobody's
That's
happy.
That's extraordinary.
I just can't. And there are stories that Peter spoke to me about. The cat spoke to me about that I can't mention here, which is really bad. So,
I
don't want to mention it because it was. Peter said it was all. What do they call it?
Confidential.
I'm losing it right now. So we can't say that. And it was really bad what I heard. And I'm thinking to myself, guys, if you're out there, you are listening to us. Everybody's interested in footballers' crew here right now. And Stephanie's here right now, guys. Please put some money in his account. I don't care whether you put $2 or $3, $5. Put something. We've put some money in his account. So please put some money in Andrew's account. Guys, I don't care if it's 20 cents or 30 cents. It all adds up at the end of the charity there for him, so that's the thing. So I just can't
get behind
Stephanie. Stephanie, now the other thing, I know we're going a little bit late over time now. I was doing a bit of research a few weeks ago about basketball. And this is very important, and this is a lesson for the people who run the game, and I think it's about time that they actually followed Larry Kesselman and found out his success of how the NBL is going. And how he's making it really good for the people out there, supporters who are going to the game. They're getting more people to the basketball rather than our football. What do you think of that?
Mm-hmm. Interesting. There's some people involved in basketball over the years that have done that really, really well.
Yes, yes.
Bob Turner's another one. When he was head of the King set up. Yeah, well, he did a fantastic job with that side. And, of course, he's now, the chair of Blacktown City.
Yes.
So he's moved into the football world, which is really exciting. Do you know what? There's people all around various sports where I think we could get a think tank from all the best bits of everyone.
Yes.
We'd know how to fix our game.
And my son is a really good basketballer, but he plays Australian rules football, and he played soccer once, but he's going to Australian rules football.
Yes.
When I heard from him that they're only charging $10 to get in for a doubleheader, I'm saying, hang on. Now, why is basketball doing this and football itself, as in football, soccer, if we want to call it that? Why are we not experimenting? No, they don't have the big sponsors.
Yes, they
Larry Kesselman owns the league and he runs it as his business. Is that right, Stephanie?
I believe you're correct. Yes. Don't quote me on that because I haven't done the intensive research But running it like a business is what's important. I'm in two minds. I don't want you guys to think about it, but I'm in two minds about the cheap or free tickets because I've had some people argue that devalues your product.
Yes, yes, yes.
True.
But you've got to get them through the door first. No?
That's right.
You've got to be able to give something back to the people who've come and supported the game. And I know in AFL too, sometimes what they do at some games – if they have a gold coin game.
Yeah.
They have a gold coin game once a year for charity, and they walk in the ground, put a dollar in, you go and see a footy match. I mean, what is there so different? And I do remember one game that we went to at the A-League, and they had, I think you were there with us, they had the Star Wars crowd. Star Wars.
What the hell?
Promotion of Star Wars. Did you remember that?
Oh, God. So I'll tell you what. It's
Star Wars.
Well, now, listen, before we go, because we're going to wind up too, don't we? Now, Steph, now the women's game is over. Now, who do you think is going to...
It's not over. The W League's over. The women's game isn't.
That's right.
Oh, you know what I mean. The W League.
He's lost it, Stephanie.
Well, tomorrow. Seriously, are the Dutch going to beat the Matildas tomorrow morning? What's your tip?
Oh, look, I'd love to say no, but I think they will, and justifiably. They're number four team in the world. Well, they've been playing they've been playing European Euro qualifiers. They've been playing a lot more than the Matildas. Matildas had one hit out. They don't have a full side because, of course, Ellie Carpenter's side in France, Lyon, half of them have COVID, so she couldn't travel.
Yeah,
same with Amy Harrison's side. We've got a makeshift back line at the moment. So, you know, we can't read too much into it, but I would have to say that if the Dutch don't win, then they're going to take a good hard look at themselves.
Yeah, and as I said earlier as well myself, right, saying that, that how successful Alan Stadjic is right now.
Mm-hmm.
Well, that was going to be
What could it have been like at the World Cup Australia played in last time to have this other coach that was there? Do you understand what I'm saying, Stephanie? Are we going to get political?
Yeah, I do. I think that that sort of upheaval prior to World Cup isn't great. I didn't think the Matildas played their best football at the 2019 World Cup. How much you can attribute to the upset before then, I don't know. Tony Gustavsson's got a chance for a fresh start. He specifically chose Germany and the Netherlands as these two first games because I feel that he believes that you can learn more from being walloped by really good teams than you can by, you know, a 31-0 scoreline against a minnow, and I think he's right in wanting to do that. It's just we've got to make sure that the public don't think that Matildas have gone backwards.
Well, this
it's
is
just a different. It's not apples and apples.
That's right. So
well, you want to play the best, don't you?
You want to play the best.
We're going to have to beat them, aren't we? If we want to win the World Cup,
we got to find out exactly who's going to be playing in the World Cup. After what I've heard. Some Matildas won't be playing in the World Cup, which is funny. I mean, it's ridiculous what I've heard because of the COVID situation. But anyway, that's up to them to fix it.
Now, Steph,
that's the Olympics, though, not the World Cup.
Okay, yeah.
The Olympics are first. Okay. Yeah.
Who do you think is going to play in the A-League final, the grand final this year?
Oh, wow. Let's go the teams we saw on the weekend, Melbourne City and Sydney.
Jeez.
I tell you what.
Have I disappointed some of you now?
No.
I see what you mean.
I think you can read my mind because I don't think the Central Coast, I think they're having a great patch, but Sydney FC and Melbourne City, they are a cut above them, aren't they? They're somehow the Mariners keep winning. We know that. I don't know how, but I think they're going to fall apart.
What you just
said. I hope not.
Do you know what? It'd be an amazing story if the Mariners
would be.
I hope they at least go to semi-finals. Do you know what? They could win it. They've had brilliant results.
I don't know.
Well, they're going to have to start impressing Manchester United right now. Is that right? They're going to start impressing Manchester United because Manchester United are making a bid to buy them.
Yeah, well, what's
and
going on there?
If they by any chance win the final, then they've got more of a chance of Manchester United buying them. Well, I mean, something's going on here. You know, what do you think of that? Manchester United buying them.
I think that's just a rumour.
Well, that's good. Manchester United can buy them. They can give them a W League team and prop up the rest of the W League. That's
right. And they'll change their colours to red. So how many teams' red colours do we have in the A-League? We don't have any red colours in the A-League.
This is true, but then you can look at what happens when the Manchester United and the City Football Group go head-to-head.
Yeah,
that's
exactly like it's going to. It'll be like a derby from England, exactly.
Ownership derby.
That's what it's going to be like.
That's right.
Stephanie, we're going to let you go. Sorry, we called you a bit late tonight, but
my apologies. It was my fault entirely. And I felt very bad. And can I just tell you, my Telstra is working perfectly. So sorry.
You're lucky. Well, down here, I don't know what's happening here. Honestly, we don't know what's going on here.
So your Telstra's working fine at your joint, is it? You're saying
yes. Exactly.
Well, can we come up and do the show at your house next Tuesday night? And we can bring Horace the Crow.
I will host you at my house for the show.
Please have a barbecue ready, okay? But the thing is, and the cat had the problem tonight. The cat had
and
the problem.
The cat had,
he had the problems
too.
As well tonight. Jeez.
So New South Wales has issues, Victoria's issues, but in Queensland there's no issues apparently.
I think we might have to do the show later because of the problem. That's what it is. Too many people using it or crowding the system right up. That's the thing, guys. So, Stephanie, thank you very much for joining us tonight. I hope you enjoyed yourself.
Absolutely, always a pleasure to chat. Let me know about the Marconi dinner.
I will let you know definitely about that one. Yes. Stephanie, thank you very much for joining us. Thank you.
Lovely. Thanks, guys.
Thank you, Stephanie. Thank you for joining us. Guys, that was Stephanie Brantz.
At least we had Stephanie
on tonight, guys, with this situation we had. So it's going to be a lot of you're back, boys. Well, Does Gavin want to come on? Does Gavin want to come on for a couple of minutes?
Well, I'll tell you what, it's nearly bloody home time.
Well, do you want me to...
My Uber's waiting.
You want me to get Gavin on a couple of minutes?
Well, I don't know. It's nearly bloody 12 o'clock.
We want to talk about the situation with the NPL for 5 minutes. Is that a problem?
Well, I don't know. Let's see if he's up young, Gav. I'll tell you what.
Gavin Fisher, are you there, sir? Mr. NPL, a few minutes for you, sir.
He might get there. Well, maybe I could sell him the tops.
Ask him. Great South. Gavin, we are back, Gavin. We stayed on, mate. How's that?
How are we going, guys?
It was definitely Telstra, mate. There you go.
Are we going? Sorry, I'm muting your stream, mate. What's happening? Sorry. I just come back and check and you're on, mate. How are we?
Because of the Telstra stuff is stuffing us up, mate.
We got, I think someone's cursed the show, but it's Telstra the problem because we had Peter Katholos on before and he confirmed
that's
that
right.
I've seen the top properties, yes. Very good, mate. I know.
Right, I've got three tops here. They've come back.
Do you really want to buy this, Mr. MPL?
He sent them back to me. He said they don't fit him. So I've got three tops here going for $600 as a package.
Are you serious? He sent them back to you?
He sent them back. He said, I don't want them. They don't quite fit me. So I've got the three tops. I know you can see us for whatever you do. I'm wearing a green top with the Lakers. Now, how rare is the Lakers badge? And that's going to be worth $100 on its own.
On the first show tonight, mate, I put in two offers. I don't know if you've seen them.
Yes, I saw $55.
What was it?
$50, and I upped it to $55 last offer.
Well, I think, Gavin,
get the badge.
As the auctioneer, calling it once, calling it twice, which I've sold to Mr. Gavin Fisher, Mr. NPL tonight.
No, we got
$55 done deal, mate. Love it. Thank you,
Proffies. What, for the whole three? Are you kidding me or what?
Yeah, mate, come on.
Well, Gavin.
Do me a favour, mate.
Gavin.
I think Gavin's smoking a bit of marijuana tonight, maybe.
Excuse me, thank you. Gavin, we need to
speak. We need to smoke it. There's nothing wrong with that.
We need to speak about the NPL this week. A few different, very funny situation in the NPL this weekend,
huh? Crazy results, apparently.
Yeah, that's right.
There was, mate. There was, it was also a crazy round, actually.
Yes.
It was a great win for South. 1-0 over Gully, away from home.
I actually saw the goal by, you know who? Her boy. Marcus Schroen, goal.
Marcus Schroen, his first goal back after he'd done his knee like nearly 2 years ago now.
Left footer. What a left footer.
Yeah, it was a beautiful finish. Great goal. It was
unbelievable, mate.
Magnificent finish. Like, we played really well. It was a really good game. It was a real battle. First half, it was real tight and tense, typical Green Gully away from home. Okay. They're always hard to play at Green Gully Reserve, always.
What was the weather like?
In about 30-something years there.
What was the weather like? Was it windy out there? Always windy?
No, it was the best weather in 15, 16 years of being going there, mate. There was no wind. It wasn't cold. It was fantastic weather, mate. It was magnificent.
What about the plane crash? There was a plane crash around the corner.
Yeah, of course.
Can you tell us about that?
Mate.
Any fatalities? Any survivors?
Now,
the planes weren't too bad, actually, probably. It's just coronavirus, mate. It wasn't a plane flying over every 2 minutes, mate. So it wasn't too bad, mate.
And now, how many people do you think were at that game?
About 20.
Well, it was a pretty poor crowd, actually, Harry, to be honest. I don't know. There wasn't many South fans there. I don't know. Maybe 700, maybe 800 at most.
Are you pretty poor, actually.
Pretty poor crowd. Such a good weather.
Yep.
And such a big game for us.
Yeah.
It was pretty poor crowd. I made the trip out, mate, for my second game of the year, so it was good. I was wrapped. Now, I was wrapped to be there, wrapped to see it.
Well, that's good.
Gavin, now, that was a 1-0 score.
Yeah, now, I've got a bit of a report, mate, on all the other games as well. I've been busy writing down a bit of a report for this week's NPL report, mate.
Yes.
So the other games on Friday night are Oakley 2, Knights 2.
Good result. I love that result.
You're kidding me. I thought the Knights were pretty good.
Can you repeat that?
Yeah, well, they did play well. I watched the highlights properties. Knights took the lead, a free kick from James McGarry in the 18th minute.
Uh-huh.
Then second half, Matthew Turmel scored for Oakley to make it 1-1. Nice header just inside the 6-yard box.
Oh, you said they won 2-0. How did the Knights score?
No, 2-2, I said. 2-2.
Sorry about that. I must have had a few beers.
That's right. You have actually had it.
Must be bad connection, mate.
It must be the data.
They got your brand new headphones, mate.
It's been one of those nights, mate. It's all right. Then in the 64th minute, Matthew Fischini scored a beautiful goal, making 2-1 Oakley.
Is he still going around?
Of course he's going around.
That's his second spell at Oakley, I think it is. Maybe third.
Was I right to tell you about Matthew Fischini has played for the Socceroos once, you know that? He played for the Socceroos once.
Did he? I don't think he did. I don't know. He played about 50 A-League games with a victory.
No,
so
he played one Socceroos game, and I remember that very well.
Well, I think, Gav, I think Harry had a dream about that. He's telling us.
Now,
if for sure he played for the Socceroos.
We need him back in the victory, Harry. You need him back in the victory, mate.
Are you serious?
Worthwhile getting him back.
Let me just tell you right now. 2-2, is that right? So where does that put them?
Yeah,
2-2,
two, and then Knights won a penalty in the 66 minute to make it 2-2. Yes, Alan Webb scored, so finished 2-2. So pretty, interesting result there. Oh, and then the other thing with that game was there was a 30-minute delay in the second half because a photographer on the side of the pitch got injured, and then the referee delayed the game for 30 minutes while they waited for an ambulance to come and take him away.
God. What happened to him?
A photographer.
Okay.
I don't know exactly what happened to him, on the stream, my brother was watching it on the stream on the way home in the car from Grand Gully, and he's telling me, oh, the game's been delayed by 30 minutes, the players are still out in the pitch, and blah, blah, blah. And I was like, what happened to this bloke? Has he had a heart attack? Is there something really bad with him? Like, what's going on? Like, yeah, so the game was delayed for 30 minutes because of a photographer getting injured on the side of the pitch.
What happened? Was he picking his nose and he bled to death or something? What happened?
I have some news here for you guys at one of the games.
Flash
now,
news,
one
flash
of our
news.
Top members here, Chris Philippou. He said, big 3K crowd at Preston versus Melbourne victory, MPL 3 last four. That's a big crowd.
Well, I was going to get to that later on, Harry.
Yes, that's fine. That's fine. Go on then.
Avondale, 2-0 over Eastern Lions at Avondale.
Yes. That's a good result. We like that.
Altona 2, Dandy City 2. Dandy took the lead, 1-0 after 31 minutes. Gavin Donatus then took another a 2-0 lead after 53 minutes. Nicholas Bibb for Dandy City. Then it was the late comeback for Dandy for Altona. In the 86th minute, Harrison Reed to make it 2-1.
Yes.
And then John McShane, 93rd minute, make it 2-2 for Altona. So a bit of fight for Altona to come back like that from 2-0 down with like 5 minutes to go to get an equaliser. Pretty good effort there.
Yes.
The other results were Hume 2, Port 1. Josh Bingham scored the opening, the 28th minute for Hume.
Yep.
And Marco Dalic scored the to make it 2-0 for Hume in the 90th minute. Then Port got a late consolation goal right on full time. And the last game was Bentley 1, Heidelberg 1. Brent McGrath scored in the 52nd minute for Bentley, and then 82nd minute penalty for Heidelberg. Dusan Bajovic scored.
Yes. Okay.
So 1-1 Heidelberg Bentley.
What was his name? Dusan.
So, yeah, there's a couple of interesting results
there.
He
used to play for Oakley, that bloke. Yeah.
Did you say Dusan?
Yeah, he's had a few clubs in the NPL, Harry.
Yes.
Did you say Dusan Bajovic?
Dusan Bojovic.
You're going to get us in trouble
here. Sorry, well, no, I thought I heard.
Milan Blagojevic.
The table is, mate. How ass? Top of the table, mate.
How many points ahead?
Wow. One clear of Avondale on 14. We're in second.
Well, that deserves third.
My God.
Get it going, Crumbies. Mate, I hope we do, mate. Go on.
I've blown harder than that, you know, everybody out there.
Oakley is sitting third on 12 points.
Yes.
Heidelberg fourth on 12 points. The Knights fifth on 11 points. Hume sixth on 11 points.
Yes.
Gully seventh on 10. Port eighth on 8 points. Dandy Thunder ninth on 8 points.
Yes.
Bentley tenth on 8 points. Eastern Lions 11th on 8 points. St Albans 12th on 8 points. So it's a big logjam between 8th and 12th, all on 8 points.
So the last pretty close. Now the last three will always
and
be
the bottom
relegated.
The bottom two is Altona on 4 points and Dandy City on 2.
I think they're gone already.
Where's Heidelberg situated? I missed that.
Mid-table.
Heidelberg are fourth, Ruffies. Yeah.
Oh,
four.
Yeah. Still up there.
Played 7, 1-3, drawn 3, lost 1, 9-4, 7 against on 12 points.
Okay, that's fine. Fantastic there, guys.
So they're thereabouts.
Now,
it's tight. It's only early. It's tight, mate.
It is very tight. It's too early, mate.
There's a long way to go, mate. There's a long way to go.
I usually call it by 10 games. By 10 games that you will...
Yeah, then we know what's going to happen.
Idea what's happening, Harry. Who's going to be the top side?
That's right now.
Who's going to be down the bottom? I agree with that.
Can you tell us about this game between Preston Lions and Melbourne Victory?
Yes, well, it was a BT Connor reserve on Friday night, as far as I understand. Yep. 1-0 win for Preston.
Yep.
Good crowd there by the look of it, what I've seen on the highlights. A lot of Victory hooligans turned up, Hordo and North Terrace themselves.
To jump the fences again, was that right or what?
Oh, they were all there, mate.
No.
All dressed in full black and ready for anything that's going to come their way. So, but didn't hear anything about any trouble or anything like that. But they're all mates, Preston and Victory. Yes. Half the Preston supporters support the Victory anyway, mate.
Yes.
Who wants to put up with State One for the last 10 years, mate?
You know what I mean? See you later.
Honestly, mate. Let's be honest. Come on.
See you later. And now, who's actually the coach of is it anybody popular coach of Melbourne Victory in NPL 3?
Vaughan Coveney used to be the coach.
Yes, he was.
5 years ago.
He was the coach, yes.
But since then, I've got no idea, Harry.
Okay.
No idea. I think Grant Bredner was in charge for a while as well after Vaughan left. Grant Bredner took over.
That's where he's now
he's got the job. Now he's got the top job and he's doing well with that.
Thanks for reminding me there, Gavin. I tell you, anyway. But look, now FFA Cup games are coming on this week.
The FFA Cup. Yes, mate. Hang on.
That's rigged. The Melbourne Knights again.
Get
on with it, boys.
Fourth time in seven years we're going to play them. Fourth time in 7 years we'll play each other.
Where's this played?
At Lakeside, mate.
Oh, I'm not
happy about it. Not happy at all.
Oh, well.
The other big draw of the fifth round was Oakley versus Preston at Oakley.
Yes, gee, Preston Oakley. That's going to be a massive
game. Preston Oakley, mate.
Yes, it will be.
Very interesting.
That will be a massive game, actually.
That'll be an easy game for
Oakley. Chris Taylor's guns are firing, then. It looks like it.
Yeah, wow. It'll be, on the pitch, it'll be pretty straightforward. Off the pitch, it'll be interesting.
Mate, Oakley, I'll give you a tip right now. Oakley to win 2-0, and I think our mate douchebag Blagojevich might miss a penalty. How's that?
Douchebag, okay.
He's playing for the Burgers. The Burgers,
wrong,
mate.
Wrong Blake, mate. Where are you tonight, mate?
How can they name him douchebag?
Gavin, I think Oakley should win comfortably, really. Realistically, they should.
Sure, you can bet on that.
It'll just be interesting to see what happens with the supporters and the crowd. You know what I mean? Like, what kind of turnout Preston will have. They'll probably have a big turnout, no doubt, because it's a big game for them. And they've got no supporters.
It'll be more of a highlight if there's a punch-up than the game, really.
Well, the thing is, Froppy, that you would know. Preston will probably have a big turnout.
They'll have
a lot of their supporters come.
Oh, they have a lot of supporters. I've been to other games there.
Yeah.
Oakley have no supporters pretty much. But what will happen is you'll get these morons, mate, who want to go there and fly the flag, mate.
Hang on. Right now, you can actually fly the flags now because it's all changed again.
What I mean by fly the flag is fly the Greek flag, Greek pride,
and go there and
have a crack at Preston supporters.
Horace the Crow, the bastard, he's here every bloody Tuesday night. Just give me your view. Do you agree with him having the national flags of the country, of the team that was founded? Have the colours, but I mean, come on. I mean, leave the national flag out.
We
know the history, but you are enticing trouble. This is what happened years ago.
No.
They're going to burn the flag, then they're going to burn the stadium,
no, they won't.
Then there's going to be cops everywhere,
no.
And football will get a bad name. Do not allow the bloody flags again.
The FFA have changed that. The FFA have done that. They've changed it all. They've gone back to normals. Well, that's the FFA. Blame them.
Well, they're a bunch of douchebags. Whatever you reckon.
What happens, right, with this game, right, and when we play them or Preston play Heidelberg for argument's sake or Oakley, you get these morons from both sides who have nothing to do with the clubs,
no.
But they just want to turn up and want to make a political statement and cause trouble and cause a punch-up. That's what they are interested in. That's how the trouble starts. I've seen it many times at South, mate, many times.
Oh,
these people come, you never see them ever, and all of a sudden you play Preston and all of a sudden they turn up and then they want to cause trouble, mate.
You know what they are? They want to be historian teachers. They come in and tell us what happened 5,000 years ago.
Oh, gentlemen.
Who gives a stuff, mate?
I'm not going back to the past.
I'm just saying, go to the game, Preston, South Melbourne, Green Gully, whatever. Don't worry about the past, mate. We can't change history. Just go there and watch the game and sit next to each other and have a chat.
Yes.
Because back in the old NSL days at the start, the Footscray JUST supporters, now I know, Gav, you weren't around then.
I've heard stories about Footscray and Melbourne Croatia before.
Footscray JUST, back in the old Middle Park days, you can ask people that have been around longer than us, especially.
Peace be the sign.
The Greeks and the Yugoslavs used to sit next to each other. And that's what you want.
Boys,
so what?
Leave it alone now.
I'm just trying to point out what happens and just try and say, look, the proper fans of Preston, the proper fans of South, we're not really that interested in getting involved with politics. We're there for the football, mate.
I understand.
It's these other people who come from outside the clubs who want to bring politics in, who want to cause trouble, who want to have punch-ups, and then it brings us all under the same umbrella. It's a South problem. It's a Preston problem.
Exactly.
No, it's not. It's a much bigger problem. It's not involved with South and Preston, mate. Exactly. Really.
Gentlemen, what's happened has happened. We've moved on. Things have changed. We hope things have changed.
Yeah, but that's Harry, they're bringing in the national flags again.
I don't want to go back there again, guys.
No, they're bringing in the national flags, and you mark my word, I hope I'm wrong, Gav, but there's going to be trouble again. There's going to be one person there who's going to say, 5,000 years ago, Alexander the Great.
No, I'm not going through
it
again.
And next thing you know, there's a punch-up.
Gentlemen,
it's going to happen again.
Well, boys, we're not here to argue.
Saying, of course, that's what I say about.
We just have to agree that we hope that nothing happens. That's all we can say.
Exactly,
right?
Harry. I agree.
I'm not saying anything.
And talking about this,
we're not
going to
go political. We're not political here. We're not biased.
Correct.
Sorry.
No, we're not.
That's what I'm trying to get across as well, Harry. That when I say what I'm talking about, I hope people understand that I'm coming from a neutral perspective here. Yeah, I might be South. You know what I mean? But I'm trying to just like say, look, this is how I see it from my perspective. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Like as an Australian, you know what I mean? Like who's not from Greek heritage, you know what I mean? But just trying to explain it. It's more of an outsiders coming to create these problems. You know what I mean? It's not a football issue.
It's political people. That's all they are.
We're all clubs.
Exactly. It's not a football issue, mate.
Just have to watch for these guys. That's all it is. That's all it is.
Correct.
Gavin, thank you for joining us tonight. We had to go over time.
Thanks, guys. Sorry, what happened?
Well, it's just the stupidity of this Telstra crap. That's all it is. So
unfortunately, we had issues before. So
that's right.
At least we did something and we got on with the show.
That's great, mate, because I was thinking that you weren't coming back on. I just come up the check and you're on. And I was like, you're back on.
Well, we had to reboot everything today.
We're back in town. How's that?
Well, I'll be rebooting everything again on Tuesday night before we start. That's what's going to be happening from now on.
Sure, nothing happened.
Gavin, thank you for joining us tonight. Thank you for joining us tonight, guys. Mr. MPL,
see you next time.
Great report. Great report.
Talk to you soon, Profi. See you, Harry.
Thank you, Gavin. Great report tonight from Mr. MPL, guys. That was amazing. So we managed the show. As I said, we have a problem with Telstra here. It's nothing to do with our equipment. It's the Telstra stuff. So we hope we've alleviated the problem. We know what to do next week as well. So
now, the song. Can I say something, please?
What bloody song now?
3 days ago, I was just quickly. This is no. I'm not talking crap here. There's a song that came on radio. I don't know what station it was. It was called "It's a Beautiful Day for a Daydream."
Oh, God.
Now, can we sing that song?
I don't do it. I've never done it in my life.
You've never done it.
So we're going to be singing
Can we sing something of the Monkees? Remember the Monkees?
Oh, mate, here we go, mate. This is the song that we finished our show
with. Yeah, we're the Monkees.
Next week, guys. Thank you for joining us, guys. Football, this was live tonight at Roxburgh Park throughout the world. That's right.
Now,
North America, the Americas, England, all over the world.
We're
going all over the world from CTV Network. And then don't forget, there is only one football.com, guys. There is only one football. The shirts, check them out. Thank you for joining us, guys. Thank you, guys. Happy to go up.
And I will say it now. Next week, we got a special guest. But Claude is on next week.
The Cup of Life. This is the one.
He's going to come on and tell us everything about the Serie A.
Don't never stop.
That Claude.
We shouldn't know. Gotta be strong.
Junior Juventus team.
We shouldn't know. Right from the top.
Now,
and when you feel the heat, the world is at your feet.
Do not.
No one can hold you back if you really want it.
She bangs.
See it in your eyes. You want the Cup of Life. Night to days, here you're gonna get it. Do you really want it? Do you really want it? Hey!
Ho!
Here we go! Ali, Ali, Ali! Go, go, go! Ali! ale, ale. Tonight's the night. We're gonna celebrate. Here we go. Good night, guys. See you next week. It's Tuesday night. Thank you, guys. Good night, everybody. Good night, one football. This is
Hi, guys. Harry Sunday here, letting you know that there's a apparel company that supports the game that you love. It's called There Is Only One Football.com, guys. They've got all sorts of stuff, from caps, t-shirts, water bottles, all sorts of accessories, even for your mobile phone, all that sporting stuff you can wear anywhere you want to wear it, guys. That's right. And don't forget the website it's on, thereisonlyonefootball.com.
There's only one football!